Hi there, Sardar here for InfoWorld. In this episode of Smart Go, I'm going to introduce the basics of reflection in Go. In programming, reflection is the ability for a program to examine its own elements at runtime and to do things like report back what type something is. Languages like Java and Python and C# offer reflection in various incarnations, and so does Go. In Go, the main use for reflection is when we use the empty interface type to accept any kind of object, and we want to extract details about the object at runtime. This is not just the same thing as checking the object against one of a number of possible types and taking action based on what that is, although you can do that. This includes the ability to do things like inspect a struct's elements dynamically. In Go, we use the reflect package to work with reflection. It provides us with a few different methods we can use to get information about data types passed through an empty interface. So let's look at this code to get some examples of what we mean by this. This code passes three kinds of variables through the empty interface into the describe function. One of these is a float, another is a string, and a third is a struct that consists of a string and an integer. The results are then inspected in the describe function by way of methods that reflect provides for us to do that. There's three methods that we're going to focus on for the sake of this introduction. Value of, type of, and kind. Value of gives us the value of the data that's passed through the empty interface. Type of gives us what type it is. Kind is a little trickier to understand. It's basically the type of a type. So let's run this code to see an example to understand what's meant by this. As you can see, the value, type, and kind for a float and a string are going to be pretty predictable. But when we pass in a structure, this is where things get interesting. The type that we get for this structure is main.movie. That's the name of the structure that we created. That's our user-created type. The kind, however, is struct. See, normally what happens is that if type and kind are the same, then that's a sign we're dealing with an instance of one of Go's primitive types, like an integer or a string. But if it isn't, then we're dealing with a user-defined type. The type will be what's the name of the user-defined type. The kind will be what that type is based on. In this case, it's struct. Now, one thing we can do with this information is use it to perform closer inspection of the components of the struct. So we have in this code a test to determine if we are dealing with a struct type. And if it is, we can use the properties of the value of result, which is of the type reflect.value. We can then use that to figure out how many fields we have at the struct. We can iterate over those fields, and we can extract type, value, and kind information from each of those fields in turn. By the way, as an aside, I'm using these special formatting codes here to print this information from each field to the console. But we could just as easily have used the value of and type of functions to do that. Now, a couple of things are worth noting here. First, the field and num field properties. These are things that only are valid if we're dealing with a struct. If we tried to call these on anything other than a struct value, the program would panic. So we have to put in this guard to make sure that we're not calling these on anything other than a struct. Second thing to keep in mind, reflection through an empty interface type can be slow compared to operating directly on known types. So you want to keep the work that you do with reflection and the empty interface types away from your program's performance-sensitive areas. You don't want to be doing stuff like this in a tight loop if you can help it. Finally, you're probably wondering how the introduction of generics in Go, which I've covered previously, changes the use of reflection. That's something worth going into in a future video. There's a lot to unpack there. But the short version is that each of these things, both reflection and generics, have their places. And reflection is still useful, even in programs that already employ generics. So that's it for this video. If you liked it, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Smart Go and more Dev with Sardar, be sure to follow me on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.